Okay, so if last day, last to last day, we have checked the how to take input, how to handle a dat file using list. Okay, how to read, how to write using list. So now today, we will check how to handle a dat file using the dictionary format. Okay, so let me just go through the program once. Then we can do some tasks today from previous year's CBSE questions. So let me open this one, dictionary write. So it is similar like the list write. Okay, if I open another window for the list write, means writing a dat file using list. So this one. So take a look. Take a look, both of them are pretty much same. So look here, both the lines are same, import pickle. We are trying to open a file using same format, AB and AB, because AB denotes the append thing. The classes are already uploaded in the YouTube, you can have a look. So we can skip this part. Let me skip. Okay. So look, record equals to one, enter the details, while true, everything is same. The difference is here. Here, list val, all those value that has been taken from the user, these three values, role, name, age, and state, are being placed inside a list like this. But in case of dictionary, all of them are being placed as a dictionary with a key and value here. So this is a key, role, and this is a value. Otherwise, everything else is same. And everything is being done by the pickle.dump. So this is a ready-made method. We do not need to know the code and we do not need to know how it is working. But dump is a method that is basically writing this list or this dictionary into the file, whatever is available. Whatever you will be given here it is a dictionary. And in this program, it is a list. So whatever you will mention, that will be inserted into this file. Okay, so that is the working principle of dump. So pickle is doing everything for us. We just need to arrange the input and create a list, and sometime creating a dictionary. So that is our job. So after that, this is a normal thing. We need to give an option to user that do you want to input any more values or not. If he create yes, I will iterate the loop once again. If the user choice is no, then I will break the loop. And after the loop, I will close the file. So any doubt, anyone, Dibbo, Unurag, Priyanshu, the same thing. If you have gone through this list program, the dictionary will be similar. Just except this line. In this line, you have to explicitly mention the key values. So every time the role, name, these are the keys, because we have already checked the dictionary. Okay, so let me run this program. It will create a file like students35.dat. Okay, so let me create a file, roll number say 101, name is Priyanshu, enter the age say 15, enter the state West Bengal, say. So do you want to continue? Yes, say Libo. My bad again. Oh, sorry, just a minute. I always do this content. This file is open, it is not, okay. Just one information, look, this is a perfect example. The file is being opened, I am trying to write, but the input I have given wrong. That is, now file is open, that's why I'm not able to close it down. It is saying, try again. I'm not able to delete it, because the file is not yet closed. It is still opened in the compiler, in the idle. Okay, so let me run the program once again with some different name. This thing I always do. let me take a file name, tetstudents.10.data. I will create that. I will create a fresh file. Let me go through slowly. Okay, let me give one by one. 101. So, enter the age, say 15. Enter the state, West Bengal. Okay. Do you want to continue? Yes. Enter the role 102. Name, say Priyanshu. Enter the age, say 20. Same also. Yes, once again, 103, say Unrag. Enter the age, 25, state, same. Why do you want to continue? No. So the program is being ended. So now, if I go to the location, here student10.file has been created. If I try to read the file, same like previous, I cannot read because it will be in some binary format so that it is not human, it is not in human readable format. So you cannot read it properly. You can having a sense like, okay, this is the name, but you will not able to understand what is this. So it is in a binary format. Anyhow, now I will try how to read a file. Let me close it down. I do not require this. I do not require the list file. So now I will try to read the file. So let me read. So this program will also be same like the list read. Read using the list. So now I'm trying to read a file using dictionary. So now, okay, let me open the program of list again. Then you can relate at least. So the list program, read whole file. These two things are same, almost same. Not almost, I will say exactly same. So I have created two different programs, but the logic is same. Look, everything is same. Everything is same. Okay. Now you can see one difference only. The variable name is list val, and printing the list val. Here the variable name is d. You can even write it list val. Okay. You can write it list val. Doesn't matter. So just denoting it is a dictionary. I am taking a d, but variable name doesn't matter. You can take any name. The both the programs will be same. If anyone say, okay, the dictionary program is different than list, that is completely wrong. The reading a file is same. So let me run this program d for dictionary. So let me run this dictionary program. Otherwise, there is no such difference. Okay. I will try to read file number 10. Okay. So I need to give students 10.10. Okay. So let me run the program. So look, it is printing successfully. Okay. Printing line is wrong because I have to change the name. Here it is written like student3.that. I can change it to student 10. But just concentrate on this part, record one. It is successfully printing three lines. Any doubt on dictionary? Because I think Priyanshu is doing the dictionary for the first time. So any doubt on the dictionary? It is pretty much same. Not pretty much, it is exactly same. Priyanshu, any doubt? Anything? Okay, okay. If you have any single doubt, you can ask. Okay, so this is the dictionary read. So now I will try to update a file. So how to update? Let me show you the program, then I will request Kartik to execute this program for us. So if you want to update a file, suppose we have few records like this 101 Dibbo, 102 Priyanshu, 103 Onurag. So now I want to update the file. So what would happen? So first, import pickle is the must one. In update, so suppose I want to search a role and I want to update that role with some other value. Suppose I am searching the role for 102 for Priyanshu and I want to update Priyanshu with the name of Julia. So I will take another updated name. I will ask user, enter the updated value. Enter the updated value in the name field. So user will first give, enter the role for which you want to update the data. User will give 102 and enter the name, enter the updated value in the name field. User will give Julila's name. So in case of Priyanshu, Julila's name will be updated in the file. My intention is that. Okay, in the previous program, you can use this thing as well. This thing is basically giving a hint to computer that we are trying to use a dictionary, but it is not mandatory. I have not used in last two programs. So it is mandatory, but still, if you want, you can give a hint to computer that I want to use a, this list val is basically a dictionary. Okay, so anyway, so if you use double parenthesis, that means it is a dictionary. If you use these brackets, it will mean it is a list. So kind of that. Anyway, we have learned this already. So now update is a combined thing. Why? Because in update, if you want to update something, you have to read the file. Then you have to write the file once again. So that's why we have taken hint or the operator like RB plus. So RB plus means previously we have used, okay, in the next year question, there will be some multiple things, multiple questions will be there in your question paper. So we need to, we need to know these file operators. So RB means read binary, if you want to read a file. WB means if you want to write a binary file. Okay. AB means if you want to append a binary file. Append means, what is the difference between write and append? Suppose you have something written in the file already. Hi, hello. Now you are trying to write by. So if you open the file in WB, these values will be deleted and by will be printed, written in the file. But if you use AB, for AB this hint, so if you open the file with AB format, then after hi hello, by will be appended. So this is the basic difference between these three things. Now we will learn another new thing, that is RB plus. If you want to read a file, plus if you want to write a file, then it will be RB plus. Okay, so we are going to use RB plus format here. So after that, I will use some simple logical program that we have already learned into if and for loop programming. So found will be zero. Now I will try to read the file in the similar manner. Just ignore this line for the time being. Or let me explain. I will store the position of a record. Suppose there is some values like 101. Let me copy the output. So this is the exact file we have currently. These are the exact files we have currently. I do not require a copy. This is not in the file. That was not a part of the file. We were printing record 3, record 1, record 2 explicitly using print statement. So let me go to the program. So now, what I am doing here, I am saving a pause value here at the first of the name of the repo. Means at the starting position, let me give some hint here. So I am storing pause here, the red circle. I am storing pause here. So tail function, what is the functionality of the tail function? Tail function basically stores the position, current position of the file. So we are marking this position before reading Dibbo's record. So after that, pickle.load is just loading Dibbo's data. I am checking if the least val role, if the least val role means 101, is equals to the value the user has given. User has requested 102 and Julia. Means he wants to update the record, the name of role 102 with a new name like Julia. So I am checking here role equals to search role. If not, nothing will happen. I have not written anything in the else block. So there is no such else block. So if it is found, then what I am doing, least val name equals to updated name. Means least val name, we have already collected the value in the least val, like the previous read programs. So I am just going to update the value with the value given by the user. So what I will do next, after reading this value, cursor will come in this position. Cursor will come a faded circle. Suppose cursor will come in the next position, because next time if the file iterates, I am going to see Priyanshu's record, because the position keep changes so that we will be able to read the whole file. So I need to go back to this red circle once again, so that because I want to update the value once again. So anyway, let me show the dry run. So anyhow, Dibbo's role 101 is not matching with 10. So it will go to the next part once again. So now it will again store the current record, current position of the file into POS. Let me go back to the file. Okay, now what will be done? Just a minute. Now POS will be stored at this position. At the starting of Priyanshu's record, POS will be stored at this position. Okay. So now again, the program will iterate. List val role equals to search role. This time answer will be yes, because user has given 101. So it is matching. So what will be done? List val name will be equals to Julia. Okay. So after reading Priyanshu's file, the cursor should go to the next line. Currently cursor is at this line at the starting of Onura's record, because Priyanshu's record we have already read. We have already taken this record into the list. So currently cursor is at this pink or violet, violet circle. So now I need to go back to Priyanshu's record once again. So how to go back to this red circle? If you use f.seek and if you mention the position, the control or the cursor will go back to that position. So from this violet circle, the control will again come into this line. Okay, the control will come again to this second red circle using this f.seek. So f.tell helps you to track or to store the current address of the file. f.seek will help you to go back to that position of the file. So those two functions are new: tell function and seek function. So tell function tells us the current position of the file, and seek functions helps us to return back to that mentioned position, POS. Okay. Now what I will do, we have already have seen what is the use of dump function. I will dump the new record into the file, and I will say found equals to 1, and we do not need to print this value again. Just we will print value is updated, that's all, and break. And after this, at the end of the program, if found is still 0, I will print role not found. So any doubt on this program, anyone, because I have not shared this video earlier. So any problem, any question, any query do you have with this program? So if you can understand how to update a file, you are okay with how to read a file and how to write a file, both the things. Update is basically read something and write something back. So any doubt, anyone? Now, Priyanshu, mainly with you. So are you clear with this one? How to use tell and seek? Seek is basically helping us to go back to the to some specific position. Here the position is false. So before reading Priyanshu's value, means before reading any value, what I am doing, I am storing that position. I am first, when I am reading Dibbo's record, I am placing the pause here. But Dibbo's record is not matching with the user given value. Now, before reading Priyanshu's record, I am placing pause here. Now, Priyanshu's record is matched because user has already given 102. Because user want to update this record 102, the name, the user wants to update. So now it is being matched with Priyanshu's record. So now the control comes at this position already after reading Priyanshu's record. Now I need to go back to this previous position once again. From here to here, I need to go back. So what is the way to go back to the previous position? Seek function basically does the same. Seek function helps us to go back to a particular position. Here the position is pause, because we have already stored that position earlier. Before reading Priyanshu's value has been stored by this line. So before reading Priyanshu's value, we are storing this current position into the pause, into the variable pause. And here in this line, we are just trying to go back to that position, because we need to dump the value once again with the new updated value. Here, after the update, the value will look like this. So I need to go back to the starting position. That is the use of seek function. Any doubt, Anurag? So my part is basically done. Now I would request Sartaki to execute this program, because there is some problem going on my machine. So Sartaki, if you can you please share your screen and execute this program? Just take an input from the user and just run the same file. And the same thing happens for the list as well. So this is the program for dictionary. Today we will check some program from the in the next session. We will check some previous year's question. Yeah. First, write a file, dictionary write. Yeah. Just take three inputs from the user. Okay. The file name is students55. Okay. Perfect. Okay, perfect. No, yeah. So just read the file, what we have inserted. Close this one. We have already checked this. Yeah. Now try to read the file, student 55. Okay. Look, the value has been inserted correctly. Okay. What happened?
Sorry, sir. There were already some values in
student 55. Okay, on this file. Okay. Yes. Okay. Can you just try to write a new file? Otherwise,
okay, sir. I'm making it right.
Yeah. Just take a new file, say students.100, students100.that or something like
that. But I'm deleting this one. Then it will
okay. Work. The same program that I have already shown you. Perfect. So, yeah. It is an entirely new file. Now you can try to read the file. perfect. Look, the data is perfect. Just remember the records. One is A, two is B, three is C. Okay. So now I will try to update the role to the name. I will try to update is D. D for Delhi. Okay. So just close. Yeah. So open this program. Yeah. The same program using tail and seek. Look. And just Shatuki, do one thing. Just delete the line, print list well. Print list well.
Sorry.
I do not need to print it. Yeah. So it is the same program we have done just a few minutes back. And just try to read. Okay, everything is fine. Just read. Try to update the file. Yeah. Run the program.
So
user is asking to update a data. So I will give a two, roll number two. And the value will be given like D. Yeah. Just enter. Yeah. It is showing value is updated. Now close the file. Yeah. And just try to read the file once again. That the file has been updated correctly. Okay. Look, role 2 is being updated with the name D. Okay. So you do not need to run the program in front of the means in your board exam, but it is good to practice those. Okay. Because it is very easy one. So if we have learned how to read a file, how to write a file, and how to update a file, then we can do anything. We can do anything.
And so there, I have updated the same thing with list as well.
Okay, you can show that as well to us. The program will be same, I guess. You can compare
yes,
as
sir,
well.
Just,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, just so write.
I'm taking only two values. Role
yeah.
And name.
Yeah, the same program we have already checked. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Perfect. Yes. Perfect. So just read the file. I think file was present previously, but still here. Yeah. The same thing we have checked today, the read program. So, okay. There was values already, but still it is okay. 1A, 2B, 3C, 1A, 2B, 3C. Okay. So now I will try to update. Two. This is a list program. So I will try to. Okay. So this is the program. Same program. Look. So two. Yeah. Okay. So value is updated. So two values were there. So both the values are updated with D. Now just read the file once again. Yeah. The same program. Look, everyone. Just. You can pause the class or pause the video and take a look. The programs are same. Okay. Just we are doing the same thing using list. Look, the value for record for role 2 changes in both the occurrences. In record 2 and in record 5, in both the occurrences, the value has been changed. It is being updated correctly. So any doubt? Otherwise, in the next session, I will show how to take the values, how to read and write using some function. And then I will jump into the CBSE previous year's question. Okay. So just join again. I'm ending this session. Just join again.